The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting group. Get involved with Access Fort Wayne and make your own television programming. Call 421-1250 to find out more.
Today on Wesley's TV, we are going to be talking about sharks. We have a special guest today. This is Monster here, and he's going to give us some facts on some of the sharks that swim in the ocean. All right, Monster.
So the biggest shark there ever was a megalodon. The biggest shark now is the whale shark, and the hammerhead shark is like one of the only sharks that has like a tip, like a cornered head on each side of his, by his eyes. And that's,
what do you think, is that about, what about the great white shark? You know anything about the great white sharks?
Yeah.
Okay, tell them about the great white sharks.
The great white shark can be camouflaged under anywhere because the top of it's blue and the bottom of it's white, and if it flips, if it's just normal up, it will blend in with the water. And it, when it's on the bottom of thing trying to catch its prey, they won't be able to see it because the bottom part of it will, the white would be camouflaging it.
So stay tuned for more on Wesley's TV.
Hey, this is Wesley's TV, and James and Monster said, we're going to be learning about sharks. We will be learning about the different types of sharks, including mako shark, the whale shark, hammerhead shark, and James, what other type of sharks are we going to learn today?
We'll also learn about the great white shark, the angel sharks, and the basking sharks.
We will also play a song possibly known, you all might know this one, called the baby shark.
The baby shark song, let's play it.
Baby shark.
TV. Next on Wesley's TV, let's explore sharks. We will be learning about the Mako sharks, a school of speed tuna swims in the open ocean. A large slender shark with a pointed nose follows them. Its crescent-shaped tail fin swishes through the water in short, powerful strokes. This is the Mako shark. Did you know that, Jerry?
No, Rose, I did not know that. It was one of the fastest predators in the ocean. Its blue, black, silver sides and white belly help it blend into the water. The tuna do not notice the sharks below them. With the burst of speed, the Mako devours the tuna.
The name Mako shark can refer to either the short fin Mako or the long fin Mako. However, it most often refers to the more common short fin Mako. This shark is named for its short pectoral fins. Did you know that?
Short fin usually grow to between 6 and 8 feet long, but they can reach lengths of up to 13 feet. Females are often larger than males. Some adults, short fins weigh over 1,000 pounds. Wow, that's a big fish.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Long fin makos are like the short fins, but they have longer pectoral fins and darker coloring around their mouths. They swim in some tropical and temperate seas as short fins, however, they are often found at greater depths. Did you know that?
Didn't know that, Rose.
Jay, did you know that the Mako shark is the fastest shark in the ocean?
No, we didn't know that.
It can go reach speeds over 40 miles then.
Wow.
Wow, wait, yeah.
That's really fast.
40 miles an hour.
That is really fast.
Yeah. The Mako has two dorsal fins. They help the shark to keep its balance while it's in the water, of course. The predator fins let it steer. The Mako always is powerful tail fin from side to side to move forward. Okay, that's how it propels itself forward, its tail. It often builds up speeds and leaps out of the water at heights of over 20 feet high. Wow.
That's pretty high.
Yeah.
Mako skeletons are made of cartilage instead of bone. This lets Makos bend and turn quickly when they chase prey. The Mako's body is covered with dermal denticles. These tough scales are made of the same material as teeth. They protect the shark from injury and help it move smoothly through the water. Did you know that, Gary?
Wow, got teeth on the outside.
Did you know
Scientist.
Determine.
And Mako age by growth.
Wings
in its backbone. Some
scientists.
Estimate there live
lifespan
to be over 30 years.
No, we didn't know that. SpongeBob, that is really cool. Their lifespan is like over 30 years. Wow.
That is
really cool.
Yes. Wow.
That is really neat.
The Mako is a prized game fish. Sports fishers enjoy the challenge and excitement of catching this active shark. After it is hooked on a fishing line, the Mako is famous for leaping out of the water. Its strong fighting spirit can be dangerous, very dangerous. Makos have been known to charge the boat. Some even leap into them and damage boat and injures the actual fishermen.
Wow,
yeah. That's a dangerous fish.
Makos have also caused serious injury to swimmers and divers. Several attacks have even resulted in death. Though people who swim or dive in Mako territory must be careful. Encounters are rare. Makos are usually found in the deep ocean. Did you know that?
Uh-uh. Never been to the deep ocean.
And stay tuned for more on Wesley's TV.
Yes, stay tuned for more on Wesley's TV. Yep.
With shark populations increasing, there have been more and more sightings along Southern California beaches. We've worked very closely with lifeguard agencies from San Diego to Santa Barbara to develop protocols on how to best advise the public when sharks are sighted. If you go to the beach and you see shark signs, pay attention to those. The lifeguards put those up for your safety, and they're important to keep you educated and informed about what you might encounter if you go to a beach. It's always good to stay in a group. Always follow lifeguard instructions. And remember, a crowded beach is a beach where sharks don't tend to visit, so those tend to be the safest beaches. If you do see a shark, what we always recommend is keep your eyes on the shark. Let the shark know that you see it. Most cases when people encounter sharks, the shark's just passing by. It's just checking them out. There doesn't appear to be any signs of aggression or threat. However, if the shark's behavior starts to change, that's when you need to pay attention. So when sharks start coming closer and moving rapidly towards you and rapidly moving away, that's a sign of aggression, and that's time when you need to back off. Always keep your eyes on the shark and make sure the shark knows that you're watching it. You can swim slowly and calmly back to the beach. If you encounter a shark and a shark is actually approaching you or a shark bites you, what we recommend is you should hit the shark in the eye, in the nose, or stick your hand in the gills. Those are all sensitive tissues. And quite often it causes the shark to release. So in those cases, your first response should be getting yourself to safety as quickly as possible. You want to yell for help. Don't worry about bleeding. Try to get yourself to the beach as quickly as possible. In most cases where people are bitten, the shark simply bites but doesn't remove flesh and rarely comes back. So we recommend that your primary priority is getting yourself safely to the beach. One of the things we always want to remember is that not only do we want to keep people safe when we go to the beach, but we want to keep the shark safe as well. We've worked really hard over the last 20 years to bring shark populations back from being overfished. And that's working. We are seeing more and more sharks in our coastal waters, and we need those sharks. They are very important animals in our marine ecosystem. They help keep our marine mammal populations healthy, and they also help keep our fish populations healthy. We need those sharks in our coastal oceans. We also need to learn to share the ocean with these animals. If you want to learn more about our research and learn more about what we're learning about sharks, you can come to the Shark Lab website, CSUOB Shark Lab, our Facebook page, or our Twitter account.
Next on Wesley's TV today, we will learn about whale sharks. My son Monster helped us with the idea for today's theme. Did you know that, Rose?
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I like that idea because sharks are one of my favorite things.
Heck yeah.
Yeah, in the warm waters off the coast of Australia, three divers take in a dreamlike scene. Sunlight streams through the water. Small schools of fish dart back and forth. Among them floats a whale shark, the largest fish in the sea. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that. The massive shark dwarfs the divers. It opens its huge jaws and sucks in water to find food. The force pulls the divers a little bit closer to its giant mouth, but the divers know they are not in danger despite its enormous figure. The whale shark is a gentle creature.
I didn't know that.
Do you know whales are mammals and sharks are fish? The whale shark is a fish named
Simply.
For its large
size.
No, we didn't know that. That's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
It's a large fish. That's definitely cool. Whale sharks live across the Gulf in every tropical ocean and sea except the Mediterranean. They are usually found at or near the surface of the ocean sea. Patterns of pale spots and stripes cover their gray or brown backs. Their bellies are all white. This countershaping helped them blend in with sunlight ocean waters. Did you know that, James?
The whale shark can measure more than 40 feet long and weigh more than 30,000 pounds. Its skeleton is made of cartilage. This helps the shark move gracefully through the water. The caudal fins help propel the shark forward as the rear part of its body moves slowly from side to side, and two dorsal fins and two pectoral fins help the shark balance and steer.
Did you know that every whale shark
spots
a
unique
pattern of the
stripes. Scientists
use the pattern to
identify interdimensional
whale sharks.
Yeah, we didn't know that either, that using the spots and stripes to identify the whale sharks is a pretty cool idea.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Whale sharks mainly live alone after they are born. However, smaller fish often hover on their backs or under their bellies. They use the whale sharks as protective shields while sharks migrate in search of food. This sometimes brings hundreds of whale sharks to the same food source. They seek out plankton, their favorite meal. Did you know that?
No.
That's pretty cool.
Like the sea meets every shore, not an
desire and fire in the rain.
On a race, so we can motivate this generation of our people to the center stage.
Undivided, we are one. When it's said and done, just try and become a better man, a better son. No shadows if you face the sun.
You could try to run, but it's only that far. Fall in the sky if you aim for the stars. Out of this world, feel like we hit the ceiling, breathing like we living up on Mars.
Never the same, people gonna change, shivering in pain.
Remember to dance like nobody's ever really watching you. They can't see your tears fall in the rain.
Rain, rain, rain.
Nobody can see a teardrop in the rain.
Like the sea meets every shore, not an if, but it's a when. From beginning to
nothing to lose, just give it all. Ain't nothing wrong with you taking the fall. If you feel twice, then get up on the third and make sure that you come back on and standing tall. Some days you just gotta try, take a leap of faith, you might even fly. Ain't nobody can stop you, and the only limit that you got up here is the sky.
Asking why, looking for signs, search through the end of time. Lost, can't seem to find a peace of mind.
Here's a peace of mind. Ever thought about the strength you possess? Life throws you obstacles to test you, just only so that you can bring out your best. I gotta confess,
like the sea meets every shore, not an if, but it's a when.
Until the
from
end,
from beginning to the end, I am fire in the rain.
Let it burn
now. I've been through it all before, and I'd go through it again.
I can't stop.
Feel
now.
Feel me burning from within, 'cause I am fire in the rain.
Let
'cause
it burn
I am
now.
Fire in the rain.
We are one, when it's said and done. Just try and become a better man, a better son. No shadows if you face the sun. Never the same, people gon' change. Even in pain, remember the days like nobody's ever really watching you. Watch the fire burning in the rain.
Like
come
the sea meets every shore, not an if, but it's a when.
Until the end,
man.
We got some kind of monster spirit or something in the audio room. A ghost. Okay, Wesley TV audience here. We're experiencing technical difficulties. Please stand by. Beep. Sorry, I'm making things too fun here.
Okay, well,
sharks mainly live alone after they are born. However, smaller fish often hover on their backs or under their bellies. They use the whale sharks as protective shells. Whale sharks migrate in search of food. This is sometimes brings hundreds of whale sharks to the same food source. They seek out plankton, their favorite meal. Did you know that, James?
No, that's new to me. Every whale shark has hundreds of tiny teeth, however, they are of little use in eating. Instead, the whale shark consumes plankton by filter feeding. The shark opens its jaws and sucks gallons of water into its mouth. Tiny plants and animals get caught in the shark's gill rakers while the water flows through the gills. Then the whale shark swallows its catch. That's a new one.
A whale shark often eats on the go. Sometimes it feeds upright with its head pointing toward the surface. Food flows into its mouth as the shark bobs up and down. Well, sharks also like to snack on fish eggs when snapper fish release their eggs into the water. Well, sharks are nearby to fill up on the tiny prey. In fact, they are known to travel long distance for fish eggs. Did you know that?
No, that's
a new one on me too.
The coral spawning off the coast of Australia attracts many whale sharks every April. When plankton or fish eggs are not enough, a hungry whale shark might scoop up sardines, squid, or tuna.
Young whale sharks are easy targets for quick predators like blue sharks, orcas, and merlins. Predators are less likely to attack adult whale sharks because of their size. If they do, a whale shark's skin offers protection. It can be over 4 inches thick. If damaged, it can heal completely over time. This protection allows the whale shark to live up to 100 years. Please stay tuned for more on Wesley's TV.
kids do everything they can to stay away from school, but that is not the case for one local student who's actually petitioning for an easier way of getting there. News Channel 15's Drew Blair explained in a story you'll only see here.
It's easy enough for Wesley Pollard to get to school when he has to be there. He takes the school bus. On the times when he wants to go, like for football games and other activities, it takes more work.
I ride the city buses all the time and go past every other high school except Wayne.
His family relies on public transportation to get around. When Wesley started school at Wayne High School this year, he quickly realized there's no CityLink route to be seen. That's when he took the matter and a mission into his own hands.
It's been an amazing undertaking. He started this the first day of school. He came in and wanted permission to get a petition going to have a CityLink bus out. Have a stop out at Wayne High School so he and his family can attend more events. I thought it was great.
This is the closest bus stop available to Wesley and his family to Wayne High School. You check it on the GPS, it's a hefty walk, 2.1 miles.
That's about 45-minute walk.
Wesley hopes to collect 1,000 signatures in support of more CityLink service. He'll present those to officials who say they'll listen.
Anytime I see someone of that age with the chutzpah enough to figure out how to work within the system to get something, they have my respect.
CityLink GM Ken Housden says he gets suggestions for routes all the time, and each one is taken seriously. Teachers and staff are in full support of Wesley, knowing a bus will benefit not just him, but many others.
That bus would really help a lot of our families from more of the inner city to come out to Wayne and talk to our teachers, talk to administration, come to sporting events, awards nights. So I think it would be great for our school community.
After CityLink heard about the petition from us, leaders said they will investigate Wesley's wish.
We're trying to save us out by Wayne because we need help.
Well, how did you get the idea to do a petition?
I was talking to one of the bus drivers about it, and they gave me the idea about it. So we said, well, might as well do it.
It's been an amazing undertaking. He started this the first day of school. He came in and wanted permission to get a petition going. That bus would really help a lot of our families from more of the inner city to come out to Wayne and talk to our teachers, talk to administration, come to sporting events, awards night. So I think it would be great for our school community.
Next we will be learning about sharks or hammerhead shark. I can tell you a few facts about them. And hammerheads have pointy tips by their eyes, and their eyes are really far away from the other eye. They have sharp teeth, and
a hammerhead shark is its head looks like a hammer. Sharks live in the ocean. They spend all their lives there. We breathe in air. Sharks breathe in water. Did you know that? Jerry?
There's probably air in the water, isn't there?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This hammerhead is about 5.5 yards long. Woo, that's a long shark. It is gray on the top, and it is white on the bottom. Fins help it swim, of course. Its tail fin is long on the top and short on the bottom.
Oh, yeah.
Probably gives a lot of speed as it goes through the water.
Mm-hmm, it does.
Okay. Look at the shark's head. Can you find its eyes?
Oh, yeah. The shark's strange head helped it find animals in the ocean. It also helps the shark to swim. Its eyes are on each end of the hammer.
Isn't that something?
Oh, yeah.
The hammerhead has big teeth in its mouth. It has about 25 teeth on the top and 25 teeth on the bottom. The hammerhead attacks rays, rayfish, attacks squid, octopus, and small sharks.
Hammerhead sharks like to live in warm oceans. They smith where the water is not too deep. They swim close to the shore. They can find lots of food there. Did you know that, Jerry?
Mm-mm. Well, it's probably a lot of food at the bottom of the ocean.
Oh, yeah.
You're right. Sharks are very strong, okay, fish. Their tails are full of muscles. This can help them swim very fast. They sink to the bottom of the ocean if they stop swimming.
Oh, yeah.
They just sink like a rock, don't they? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Hammerheads can have up to 40 babies at a time. The babies are called pups. A pup is about 23 inches long when it's born. It swims away from its mother and hunts for food as soon as it's born. Did you know that?
Wow. They don't feed off its mother, huh?
Mm-mm. I think that's pretty cool.
There are different kinds of hammerhead sharks.
Born to hunt.
Hammerhead sharks.
Including.
Bunnet head.
Stout.
Hammerhead.
Wayne head.
And the great. Hammerhead is the
biggest
of the all. Of all, now we know the hammerhead shark are any
amazing
animal. Please stay tuned for more on Wesley TV. Next on Wesley's TV, we will be learning about angel shark. Angel shark lives in ocean there, like warm and shallow water.
That's pretty cool. They like warm, shallow waters. Angel sharks do not look like other sharks. They look more like stingrays. Their bodies are long and fat. Did you know that, James?
No. The pectoral fins are broad. Their tails look like the same as other shark tails.
Angel sharks can be brown. They can be reddish or gray, too. They have light and dark markings on their bodies.
Angel sharks are bottom dwellers. They hide in the sand. They wait for prey. When prey swims by, angel sharks lunge. They trap prey with their strong jaws and sharp teeth.
Yeah, I've seen them before.
Yeah, I've seen them before.
Angel sharks eat many kinds of fish. They also like squid and octopus. They eat other animals too. Did you know that?
No. Baby sharks are called pups. Angel sharks give birth to around 10 pups. After birth, pups are on their own. They're about 9 inches long. They will grow to around 60 inches. Man, that's pretty good size.
Yeah, it is.
Did you know that the
Japanese
angel shark is the
largest
shark
species?
It can grow up to
6.5
feet long. Angel sharks
believe
the
definitely
from other sharks. Most sharks need to move to
breathe.
Angel sharks do not live more than 30 years in the wild, but please stay tuned for more on Wesley TV.
Like the sea meets every shore, not an if but it's a when. From beginning till the end, I cause I am fire in the rain.
On a race, so we can motivate this generation of our people to the center stage.
Undivided, we are one. When it's said and done, just try and become a better man, a better son. No shadows if you face the sun.
You could try to run, but it's only that far. Fall in the sky if you aim for the stars. Out of this world, feel like we hit the ceiling. Breathing like we living up on Mars.
Never the same, people gonna change, shivering in pain.
Remember to dance like nobody's ever really watching you. They can't see your tears fall in the rain. Nobody can see a tear drop in the rain.
Like the sea meets every shore. Not an if, but it's a when. From beginning to the end, I am fire in the rain. I've been through it all before, and I'd go through it again. Feel me burning from within, cause I am fire in the rain.
Nothing to lose, just give it all. Ain't nothing wrong with you taking the fall. If you feel twice, then get up on the third and make sure that you come back on and standing tall. Some days you just gotta try, take a leap of faith, you might even fly. Ain't nobody can stop you, and the only limit that you got up here is the sky.
Asking why, looking for signs, search through the end of time. Lost, can't seem to find a peace of mind.
Here's a peace of mind. Ever thought about the strength you possess? Life throws you obstacles to test you, just only so that you can bring out your best. I gotta confess.
Like the sea meets every shore. Not an if, but it's a when.
Until the
From
end.
From beginning to the end, I am fire in the rain.
Let it burn
I've
now.
Been through it all before, and I'd go through it again.
I can't stop.
Feel
now.
Feel me burning from within, cause I am fire in the rain. Cause I now. Am fire in the rain.
We are one, when it's said and done. Just try and become a better man, a better son. No shadows if you face the sun. Never the same, people gon' change. Even in pain, remember the days like nobody's ever really watching you. Watch the fire burning in the rain.
Like the sea meets every shore. Not an if, but it's a when.
Until the end now.
This is SpongeBob.
Yeah, don't do me.
I'm feeling spongy. How are you guys doing out there? Can you guys hear me?
Yeah,
we heard you. How's it going, Rose?
Doing good.
How's it going, Jerry?
Yep.
Jerry. I'm just kidding. So next on What's the TV, we will be talking about learning about basking sharks. Shark baby.
Yeah, basking sharks live in oceans around the world. They are often seen near land. They enjoy warm, shallow waters. Basking sharks swim slowly. They bask in the sun. This is how they got their name.
Basking sharks are huge. Only whale sharks are bigger.
Okay, basking sharks have small eyes. They have large noses. Basking sharks have large nostrils, fins. Okay, they can easily spot their prey.
Basking sharks have huge mouths. They open their mouths as they swim. Their mouths catch food and water. Their special gills separate food from water. The water goes back into the ocean. They eat what is left.
basking sharks often eat humans, such as you, Rose, and you, Jerry. No, I'm just kidding. They eat plankton. Man, he deserves to eat such a mean, mean person.
Baby basking sharks are called pups. Pups swim away from their mothers after birth. So please stay tuned for more fish stories on Wesley TV.
Hey, what's up, Rose, and what's up, James?
Doing good. How about you, SpongeBob?
Not too bad. You know, speaking of SpongeBob, that's me. Hi. Hi, everybody. Hi. We're all high out there. We're all watching the show. We're all high. We're all saying hi to everybody. But anyways, we're talking about sharks, and we're talking about great white. Now, as being an entertainer, as I am, you know, on a certain channel, but again, there's also a music group called Jack Russell's Great White. You guys remember that group?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Once Bitten, Twice Shy. Rock Me, and they did some other things. So again, an interesting fact that Jack Russell's Great White has an obsession with sharks. Just wanted to throw that out there too, but like I said, we're learning about sharks as well, so let them know about it on the learning tree.
Yeah, a great white is a shark. It looks scary to some people. It can swim very fast. Look at those enormous teeth. Great white sharks hunt animals to eat. Did you know that, James?
Is it a fish? Yes, because all sharks are fish. Fish have fins. They breathe underwater. Sharks use their gills to breathe. A great white has a dorsal fin on its back. It has a big fin at the end of its tail.
Great white sharks are super swimmers. They have long, strong bodies. A shark's body is a good shape of moving in water. Great whites are so strong they can leap out of the water. Hey, SpongeBob, how many teeth do they have?
They have a lot of teeth. Look at the shark's mouth. How many teeth can you see? Ow! 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 Hey! Hey! Ooh, they need to brush his teeth. Ooh! Ooh! Ooh-wee! Ooh-wee! Ooh, sorry. Can you see? Here's the tooth of a great white shark. What shape is it? When a tooth falls out, it takes a new one over its place. Wesley, why are you signing me up to get bit by a shark?
Great white sharks live in the oceans. They swim near the shore. It is hard to see a shark in the water. The shark has a dark back and has a white belly. Did you know that?
Yeah. I tell you what, the great whites, they're one of my favorite sharks that I've learned about.
Yeah, they're pretty cool.
Yeah, they're really cool. I like them. A great white shark swims silently in the ocean. It is looking for food to eat. The shark has two small black eyes. The shark's nose is called the snout. Did you know that, James?
No. The oceans are full of food for a hungry shark. Great white sharks like to eat fish, dolphins, seabirds, and other small mammals.
Shark can smell a seal. Now it can also see a seal. It's time to attack and you never go back. Shark grabs the seals by its jaws and one big gulping. It is good, 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 good in my belly, 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 belly. Well, shark's belly, not my belly.
Yeah, great white sharks have babies every 2 or 3 years. Baby sharks are called pups. A great white pup is about 51 inches when it's born. It will grow much bigger. Did you know that, James?
No, that's pretty good size for a baby.
Now we learned about great white sharks and our amazing animals. Please stay tuned for Wesley TV. Let me tell you what, we're learning about sharks not only this episode, but the next episode. Ready to be eaten by one. No, I'm just kidding. Stay safe of sharks. Watch for them. Make sure they don't come against you. But stay tuned on Wesley TV for more. And I say more, 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 more. And be like a sponge and I'll soak it all in. Love you guys.
With shark populations increasing, there have been more and more sightings along Southern California beaches. We've worked very closely with lifeguard agencies from San Diego to Santa Barbara to develop protocols on how to best advise the public when sharks are sighted. If you go to the beach and you see shark signs, pay attention to those. The lifeguards put those up for your safety, and they're important to keep you educated and informed about what you might encounter if you go to a beach. It's always good to stay in a group. Always follow lifeguard instructions, And remember, a crowded beach is a beach where sharks don't tend to visit. So those tend to be the safest beaches. If you do see a shark, what we always recommend is keep your eyes on the shark. Let the shark know that you see it. Most cases when people encounter sharks, the shark's just passing by. It's just checking them out. There doesn't appear to be any signs of aggression or threat. However, if the shark's behavior starts to change, that's when you need to pay attention. So when sharks start coming closer and moving rapidly towards you and rapidly moving away, that's a sign of aggression, and that's time when you need to back off. Always keep your eyes on the shark and make sure the shark knows that you're watching it. You can swim slowly and calmly back to the beach. If you encounter a shark and a shark is actually approaching you or a shark bites you, what we recommend is you should hit the shark in the eye, in the nose, or stick your hand in the gills. Those are all sensitive tissues, and quite often it causes the shark to release. So in those cases, your first response should be getting yourself to safety as quickly as possible. You want to yell for help. Don't worry about bleeding. Try to get yourself to the beach as quickly as possible. In most cases where people are bitten, the shark simply bites but doesn't remove flesh and rarely comes back. So we recommend that your primary priority is getting yourself safely to the beach. One of the things we always want to remember is that not only do we want to keep people safe when we go to the beach, but we want to keep the shark safe as well. We've worked really hard over the last 20 years to bring shark populations back from being overfished. And that's working. We are seeing more and more sharks in our coastal waters, and we need those sharks. They are very important animals in our marine ecosystem. They help keep our marine mammal populations healthy, and they also help keep our fish populations healthy. We need those sharks in our coastal oceans. We also need to learn to share the ocean with these animals. If you want to learn more about our research and learn more about what we're learning about sharks, you can come to the Shark Lab website, CSUOB Shark Lab, our Facebook page, or our Twitter account.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Please subscribe to Wesley TV on YouTube.
God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. How great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son, not sparing.
Each school year, there are more than 15 million stop arm violations. It has to stop.
Stop for me.
It has to stop.
Stop for me.
We need your help to make a difference and keep our kids safe. Slow, stop, stay. Slow.
Slow for me.
Stop.
Stop for me.
Stay.
Stay for me.
Slow, stop, stay.
For us!
Beginning with the 2018-2019 school year, all LTISD school buses will be equipped with seatbelts. It is important for seatbelts to be worn correctly so that all students are safe while riding the bus. Let's show you how. First, click, then tug and snug. That's right, just click, tug, and snug. Great job. Make sure to stay buckled in for the entire ride. In an event of a crash, wearing your seatbelt may prevent serious injury and can even save your life. Remember, as soon as you board the bus, make sure to click, tug, and snug. Safety first.
TV, letting you know, PSA today, you need to wear
seatbelt.
They will be the first ones out the gate.
Do not follow too close, because we just had a collision out here just a second ago. That's number one and number two. Number three.
Moses Bay Pet Pete.
There's also no bumper cars, okay? They're not bumper cars. They are go-karts. It's very dangerous when you try to play bumper cars with these. They're not bumper cars, they're go-karts. Okay, that's my PSA for today, people. Go have fun and be safe. Later, guys.
Hi, my name is Evelyn, and I am the one that crashed the go-kart. I am okay. I just have this little goose egg right here. But I am okay. And what happened was that I was turning this way to go into the go around the lap thing one more time, and it let go of it, and it like turned all the way around and it crashed into the wall. But I am okay. And be careful when you're riding those go-karts. Okay, bye.
Back up.
The more we get together.